Good afternoon. Welcome to the Reading Parking Authority program. My name is Reimundo Encarnacion, your host and executive director for the Reading Parking Authority. Today we have as our guest Mr. Kevin Woznicki from the Barnacle Group.
Thank you, Ray.
How are you today?
Doing great, thanks. How about you?
Great, great. Kevin, can you please tell us a little bit about the Barnacle and your company?
Sure.
And how did this start?
Well, it's an interesting story. The concept started in Europe, believe it or not, when the actual inventor of this product kept on getting boots in London. So between the mess that a boot causes, the difficulty that a person has installing it and then having to wait for it removed, this guy started thinking there's got to be a better way to do parking enforcement. So from that came this, the Barnacle. So that's kind of a little background on how the company was started. And why we started it was because we had looked at the parking enforcement market, and for years it was the same old, same old. So this is safer, lighter, greener. It certainly is going to take a whole lot less effort to get it moved around. So you're not going to have to use trucks to pull it around like you will a boot. This can fit in the side of a bicycle. It can fit in a small car. And also one of the greatest things about it is should some unfortunate motorist get barnacled, they don't have to wait for somebody to come take it off. There is a feature by using the keypad that the user can release it themselves.
Ed, Kevin, when did this idea start?
It started about 3 years ago, and what we have done is once we have gotten the product development team turned loose, we started to figure out what type of suction cups, what types of plastic, what types of other types of hardware would be the best fit for this barnacle. So we debuted it about a year ago. We just turned one from a product standpoint this past week at the Pi show in Chicago. And we had our little cupcakes at the show. So we are now 1 year old with the product. And we have done extensive testing in several cities of varying climates because we wanted to make sure that especially in a city like Reading, where you've got temperature variances from being very cold in the winter to very hot in the summer, that the product would hold up. So we tested it as far north as Michigan, Colorado, as far south as Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and we've gotten to take 6 months of our time to figure out what is in those barnacles, and now we've got a unit that is coming off the production lines this month.
But when I see the regular boot, it's a metal, heavy, strong,
yes,
not easy to move, cars will not be able to drive. Why is this one better than that typical?
Well, I'm glad you asked that question. And actually what it is manyfold. The barnacle itself weighs about 14 pounds. And as you can see, does not require somebody to be on steroids to lift it.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing is, rather than having the product go on the wheel of a car, risking wheel damage, and getting somebody who installs the barnacle in a position where they're kneeling in traffic, they're putting their backs at risk. They're also could be kneeling in slush, mud, or other. This will go on the windshield of the car. So rather than having somebody bend over and kneeling in traffic, worrying about, is somebody going to run me over? Am I kneeling in something I don't want to kneel in? This would actually just fit over the windshield of the car. So what you're looking at are two suction cups that would fit over the windshield of the car, thereby totally blocking the driver's view.
Mm-hmm.
And the beautiful thing about it is that if you need to have this thing released, you do not need to get down again in that same position to do it. Either somebody from RPA could come do it, or as we mentioned a little bit earlier, there is a motorist release feature that the person could actually remove this themselves.
Okay. What about, I see that there's two suction type of devices there. Well, what is that for?
Well, these suction cups will be activated, if I can turn the barnacle over and show the front part of it. You would activate it from this keypad, and what would happen is the electric pump
would activate the barnacle, and under each cup it would put about 750 pounds of pressure on the windshield. Two spots, making sure that that thing is staying on. So when you have the cups suctioning onto the windshield, it really doesn't make any difference if it's raining, if it's sunny. A little bit of moisture will actually help the cup adhere to the windshield. So that's what the cups are for. They're commercial grade suction cups that would actually bind to the windshield. And if you've ever seen, trying to look through these from the inside of a windshield, short of pulling an Ace Ventura by putting your head out the window, or if you're lucky enough to have a sunroof, which you will see, by the way, on the next episode. This will be featured on the next episode of Modern Family.
Okay.
Come the 15th of March, you will see where the daughter gets barnacled, and her uncle actually does try to stand up through the sunroof, which, as anybody knows, is totally illegal. Okay. So, but in addition to that, should that barnacle be moved while it's on the car, you will get an obnoxiously loud audible alarm that will sound the minute that thing is moved.
How will that work?
Well, I can certainly arm the barnacle and for 7 seconds deafen you, if you don't mind. But, and I take my microphone off.
Are we still live here?
So while you do that,
yes,
Kevin,
mm-hmm.
The GPS, okay.
And you can hear it. This is going to inflate. Now what I'm going to do is manually make this thing sound. So what will happen?
So now it's on.
It's on. And if you try to move, that little thing is going to be what you hear. And this will go off in 7 seconds for this demo right now. So,
okay.
So you don't have to worry about ixnay on the octave.
So if somebody tries to drive away, this will go off.
Constantly sound.
Plus the GPS system will let the authority or any company that is using this type of equipment, we will receive a notification that...
Correct. There's also a GPS, optional GPS chip we can put in here that will tell you exactly where the barnacle is at any given time. And once again, this alarm that we just heard, which was so ridiculously loud, mm-hmm. will also sound should somebody try to remove the barnacle. So the minute this barnacle senses any type of vibration, it would really, that will be the sound you'll get. You'll get that exact same sound from an audible alarm standpoint. And it doesn't go off in 7 seconds like this one does.
I see.
That one stays on.
How much does this weigh, this piece of equipment?
This one weighs about 14 and a half pounds total weight. And that's one of the things that when we've tested the unit with the parking authorities that have tested it to date, male, female, anybody can use this. So you are not straining somebody to go do something that they're physically incapable of doing.
Can I try to lift this?
Sure. Watch my microphone.
Okay. Oh, okay. So this is really... This is what it is.
That's it. That's it. You're looking at it. That's it.
Okay.
And as I said, the beautiful thing is there's a user release function in here because sometimes we're all in a hurry. And unfortunately, parking enforcement sometimes is not the most popular thing for people to deal with. But having said that, when you do get a boot, what you'll find is that until that boot is released by whoever put it on, you are stuck where you're stuck. And there could be a myriad of reasons why you don't want to be stuck there. So what you can do with this product is, once again, using the same keypad, and I will not demo this, but we have a IVR system where you would call in, get a voice-activated system. It would ask you thank you for calling Barnacle.
Mm-hmm.
Give me your device number, which is right here. It would ask you to read the 4 digits that are in this display. You would give that to them. They would then put it in, give you a one-time release code. You would punch it into the keypad, a 4-digit release code. The barnacle will deflate, and now it's up to you, depending what Reading wants to do with it. Typically, the customer would have 24 to 48 hours to return a barnacle to Reading Parking Authority or wherever you so designate. The beautiful thing about that is you do not have to wait as a user or motorist for somebody to come release you. You can do it yourself. But make sure you return it. Because not only is it tracked, but we have your credit card.
Absolutely. Now, what has been the experience of those that have tested this piece of equipment?
Well, it's been nothing but phenomenal. We have recently launched it internationally. The 6 test sites that we've had, we had the very first one come on board. It was a hospital system in Michigan. And we just came back from the parking show in Chicago. And they were so enthused about it. And then especially when they found out it was going to go on TV on Modern Family, that they were almost, you know, jubilant about the decision they had made, because they love it. And it's just one of those things that's so easy to take on and take off, so easy to handle, so easy to use, that the people who have them literally fight over them. We have a limited number available for pilots, so people are asking more and more and more and more and more. And we couldn't make more and more and more and more because we were testing it. So all of the things we have found from the pilot has gone into this production unit.
You mentioned testing.
Mm-hmm.
And you see, we in some areas we have extreme weathers, whether it's we are in the summertime or wintertime.
Right.
How has this been tested in these weather changes and climates?
Well, we've had it in, as I mentioned, in some hot weather cities as far south as Florida. Held up very well under some extreme heat. We've had it in extreme cold, held up extremely well in extreme cold, and we've had it in temperatures, in climates similar to what you're going to see here at Reading. A town in Pennsylvania, another town in Michigan, mm-hmm. very much the same as you'll find here. And once again, we have not had any issues with any types of product variation because of temperature.
Sounds very good. Very good. So the success rate is really high.
It's very high. And if I could tell you how busy we are to try to manage what is available, and, you know, a lot of credit goes to you for being one of the first to go take a look at it, because right now it is just become an international star. We've been introducing parking products for years, and I can tell you I've never seen anything match the acceptance of this. It's just something so different and so unique that when we take a look at what our pipeline looks like, it's almost like we need to get more people.
So technically speaking, and the application of it, in the traditional way, you will need 2 or more people
mm-hmm.
with a traditional boot, the metal right. boot that will go on the wheel, and plus the any type of liability if we scratch a rim or not, or what,
right.
if anything that can happen. With this, pretty much you can say that only one person can install this.
One person installs. As I mentioned a little bit earlier, it can be installed by, we have a little bike rack that will go one on each side of a bicycle.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever vehicle Reading Parking Authority so chooses, these will stack vertically, horizontally. You don't need a big gas-guzzling vehicle driving around streets loading it up with a bunch of metal. So it is a much more efficient, greener solution than a typical metal boot.
How many can you fit in one in a car, Bruce?
It depends. I mean, if you have a small SUV and stack them alongside like this, you can get as many as 10 okay. in there. So on a bicycle, there is one basket over each rear tire, which we've developed for a couple of police departments we've worked with. So it's a matter of you, whatever you have, it'll work. And even in a small car, you'll get at least 3 or 4 of them in a trunk.
So the way that I see this is actually like, hey, you know, this is happening. Please come forward.
Yeah. It is a great thing. It's probably from everything we've heard of now, 4 trade shows where it's been the most successful parking hardware introduction to come along in a long, long time. There's been a lot of variations of the same theme in parking. Parking has not been a real sexy or exciting theme, mm-hmm. but this actually is about as user-friendly, as motorist-friendly as one can get a parking enforcement product, because, you know, this is not something that's going to tie down the motorist. You know, should he or she want to get moving, they have that ability to do that. From an authority standpoint, you're going to find the ease of use of this is second to none. And again, anybody in there, you know, capable of, you know, lifting, as you said, this little thing is is going to do it. And we've designed an awful lot of fail-safes in here, and behind these suction cups are steel plates, so nobody is going to be able to saw through it. And if they did, the minute this thing senses any vibration, that wonderful alarm that we heard will also sound.
Yes.
So it really becomes a matter of a simple solution to a very complex problem. So the Barnacle, we think, has hit all of the bases for where we wanted it to, both from an authority standpoint and also a motorist standpoint.
I see. How many cities are using these?
Right now, we have six cities officially using it. We have another, I'd say 10 who are waiting for units to go. And then we have got countries throughout Europe, Africa, South America, and Asia who are looking to put it in their into their parking authorities as well. So as we said, it's been, the reception has been phenomenal to the product. And once people get it, see how easy it is to use, see how easy it is to handle, we think it's going to be something that is going to be totally revolutionary from a parking experience.
In this same line of equipment, what other things is your company doing?
Well, right now what we're doing is trying to get this thing built, but we are similarly looking at some other technologies that we believe are outdated, similar to the boot. And we are now exploring a couple of products. Unfortunately, I can't tell you what they are. But as you looked at some of the things that have been around in parking for literal decades, there are some opportunities for simpler, more user-friendly, more authority-friendly products. So we are constantly looking to do something along the lines of making the parking experience simpler.
Yes. From your first presentation to the board, there's some people that have asked or have said, oh, well, this is easy to remove. We only have to drill a hole on the windshield.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, is that a fact? I mean, who's going to drill a...
Well, if you could drill a hole in your windshield, the best thing to do to take it off would be to remove your windshield. And of course, the minute that this product senses any vibration all around it, you're going to get that alarm again. So if you want to take your windshield off, that's probably the best way to remove the Barnacle. You know, if you want to try to pry something underneath this gigantic suction cup, you better have something that's going to be really strong. And then chances are, when you do that, you're going to break your windshield anyway.
Yes, I see that there's like right here, I see that there's like a metal.
Yeah.
Okay, this is.
Yep.
So once this will really attach all the way into the.
Yeah, see the overlapping fingers as well.
Yes.
That'll make the suction real easy, and the metal ring that we talked about that's holding it in.
Yes.
So a lot of thought has gone into making sure that this thing will do as big of a job as it can. And, you know, it's not as if somebody's going to be able to put a dipstick or a butter knife under here and pry 750 pounds of pressure off.
Plus, at the end of the day, also the GPS tracking will go off, and we will.
Yep.
Somebody will get a signal.
Somebody, depending on how we set it up with you, somebody will always know where this product is. And obviously, from a tampering standpoint, if you can stand that thing going off in your ear the whole time you're trying to do something with it, calling attention to something. And let's be fair, a bright yellow thing on somebody's windshield is not easy to ignore.
Yes.
And then it's making noise at you, it's even harder to ignore.
With this type of rubber, and I see the surrounding rubber all around, is there any possibility of a car getting scratched?
Not the car getting scratched. I mean, there would be, the only downside that we would recommend is you check for cracks on windshields before you install a Barnacle.
Okay.
Because with that type of pressure, you have to make sure that you do not install over an existing crack. And if you do, you really need to think of another plan to do that, because we don't want to get into a situation. The Barnacle will not crack the windshield. But if there is an existing crack there, we recommend there's a whole process we have outlined before it's installed, what to check for, what will not be affected, what type of crack you can still put it over. If it's any type of a spider crack, I think you pass. You don't put the Barnacle on that. But, you know, that's really the only downside. But you will, We have not seen any type of scratching with the paint of the car because it is so light. I mean, when you install it, and we put it on SUVs, for example, even in our video, most of the videos you'll see we're running are with an SUV. Mm-hmm. So it's not something that you're going to have any issues either lifting or worrying about, you know, the product itself damaging the paint.
Okay, great. Well, this looks like a great product to me.
Well, we're excited to try it with you, and, you know, being as we're relatively local and, you know, a New York-based company, New York-manufactured product, a nice made-in-the-USA product, we're really excited to try it here, and hopefully you'll experience the same thing that everyone else has who has tried it so far.
In the video, I see that how easy it is.
Yeah.
When they're installing... Replacing this boot.
That's what it is.
It looks very simple.
Yep. And all we're doing is putting it on and arming it with the electric. And this has got a manual pump, this version. This was one of the product improvements we made.
This is being changed now.
That's to this one now. That manual pump that's on the video is now an electric pump.
So it will suck in electronic.
It'll start it like we did before.
Okay. I see. Interesting. And also to remove, I guess, it's the same.
Same thing, you know. Again, if it's whether it's a user or whether you wait for the person to come, whether it's a release code from the motorist or whether it's the person that comes to remove it, they're going to have to put the same number, same code in. I would tell you what the code is, but then we have to change it. But there is a release code for the actual keypad itself. There's also a manual release should the battery die, which. Is, you know,
that's a yeah,
but there's a key that if it gets stuck on here, there's a little key slot that you can see in the top of the unit itself that would actually be the whoever the enforcement officer would come and release it manually and say you have the same thing. So even if the battery dies, and there are rechargeable batteries in here that comes with a pack,
okay,
so you do get that as well. So it's really something that. It's not going to stay on your windshield for, you know, if you want it off. So if you have somebody to come get it off, you either get it off or not get it off. But the good thing is that when you put it on there, and should the barnacle actually stay in the car longer than a couple of days, the pump has a sensor in it that will actually automatically reinflate the suction cups to keep the barnacle on the car itself for up to 2 weeks.
Up to 2 weeks?
Yes. So
extreme condition, extreme weather
doesn't matter because all it's doing is sensing the actual pressure in the cups. The minute that pressure begins to drop to a point where it's no longer a good seal, it'll reinflate the pump. It will put the suction cups back on. So
let's say the battery would
the suction part mm-hmm. still be. It will still be
right,
strong.
Right. So hopefully we won't have anything for more than 2 weeks, but, you know, at that point it will gradually degrade after that time. But for up to 2 weeks, if you have a barnacle on a car, you do have a really good seal on it.
Perfect. Very good. Well, the barnacle, great product that soon we will be seeing in the Reading Parking Authority and its application. We hope that the production is soon completed. We're anxious waiting for these products to arrive, and in the hopes that we can work together.
Well, we would love the opportunity. You know, we've been talking for a couple months about it, and we think that right now what you're about to get is far better than what you saw initially when we talked, and we would really love the opportunity to work here.
All depends on the board approval. Well, anyways, once again, thank you, the home viewers, for seeing our program. This is the Reading Parking Authority, and we hope you have a nice afternoon and great weekend. Thank you for having us at your homes. Goodbye.